Hello students, welcome to another video.
So in this video we will be discussing today that why the blood clotting is happening after taking the AstraZeneca or Johnson & Johnson vaccine. I'll be giving you the detailed information, the mechanism behind the blood clotting process and what happens when a vaccine is causing the same blood clotting process. What is the reason behind, what is the mechanism behind the blood clotting process caused by vaccine. So let's start the video without further ado. So what are these vaccine basically made up of? These are, if you talk about the AstraZeneca vaccine, then this vaccine is made up of adenoviruses, or you can say these vaccine uses adenoviruses to get the desired effect of your vaccine. Now these adenoviruses are a commonly used vectors for delivering genetic messages. Now what happens when you, these are normal viruses which gives us common cold or fever. So these are not very harmful, so that is why they are being used in vaccines. That is why they are frequently used in as a delivery agent for various vaccines. Now what happens, what is the unique property of adenovirus which makes it suitable? It is the capacity of adenoviruses to infiltrate the cells. So adenoviruses, they can enter your cells and then they can deliver your genetic message, and accordingly the result will be obtained based upon the genetic message which you have encoded in the genome of your adenoviruses. Now we can actually hack, or we can actually change the genetic messages according to our desired result. So that is why they are being used as a vector. Now we'll talk about, this is the basic principle of adenoviruses based vaccine. All the vaccines which are using adenoviruses are generally doing the same thing. Now we will talk about the blood clotting. The blood clotting and your AstraZeneca COVID-19 vaccine. Now what is the mechanism behind, or you can say what is happening, or what is the why this blood clotting mechanism is happening, why in some patient, not all of the patient, but it is very rare, but it is happening. So let's try to understand. First we will try to understand what is the blood clotting process. So if you talk about blood vessels, so let's suppose this is your one blood vessel and this is your bone marrow. This is your bone marrow and this is your normal blood vessel carrying your various blood cells like RBCs or WBCs or platelets. So now what happens is these bone marrow, they have cells called megakaryocytes. So these are the cells which are responsible for the synthesis or for the production of your platelets. So they will synthesize platelets. Now platelets, like your RBCs, are enucleated. So it will be synthesizing enucleated platelets. So they don't have their own nucleus. So some of the these megakaryocytes will produce platelets. Now these platelets will be carried to your blood vessels. Now suppose this is your one platelet. Notice the property of your platelet cell, that they have a factor or a molecule which we call as PF4. On their surface present. All platelets have this factor 4, some other factor, these are various factors which are present on platelet cells. These are present on all the platelets. So it is covered with this your PF4. Now what happens in your blood clotting, or you can say it is a heparin induced blood clotting process. So all the patients which have been given heparin, this is also a very rare mechanism, that blood clot, this thrombocytosis happens to the patient which are being given heparin molecule. So heparin is a blood thinner. Blood thinner. Now, in some patients or in very rare patients, what happens is this heparin, because of this heparin, your thrombocytosis or thrombocytopenia happens, or you can say blood clotting happens. This is basically given to avoid your blood clotting, but because in some rare patient, this heparin causes blood clotting. How this is happening, I will show you in a minute. So now, what heparin does, in normal cases, heparin, if you suppose like this is your blue molecule heparin, it will bind with your PF4. So it will make a complex PF4 plus heparin. Or okay, I can make this here also. So this is what we're calling as heparin plus PF4 complex. Now what happens after this complex formation, your B cells gets activated. B cells activation. Now after B cells activation, what they will do? What is the normal purpose of B cell? They synthesize your antibodies specific to this complex. Now they will synthesize your antibodies. After this synthesis of antibodies, these antibodies will bind to this complex. So suppose these are the antibodies. So these antibody will bind to this complex, and after this binding process, what happens is it activates your, this leads to the activation of platelets. Now once the activation of platelets happens, what is this process? It recruits other platelet cells. It gives a signal to other platelet cells that we have to do blood clotting. So this will lead to extensive blood clotting. Now what will happen at this place, if I zoom into this place, this is your one platelet and this is your PF4 and this is your bound heparin molecule. So now what will happen? This will activate further platelet cells. So these are other platelet cells. So these are other platelet cells. They start getting accumulated. Once this platelet cell gets activated, it will activate this cell. It will further activate this cell. So all this there is this is the complex of all the platelets. They are combining together and forming the blood clot. This is known as heparin induced thrombocytopenia. Heparin induced thrombocytopenia. Now this is your normal process, which is happening to very rare, very less number of patients which have been given the heparin treatment for blood thinning. Now what is the mechanism which is happening in your COVID-19 related cases? In COVID-19 cases, as soon as you give the vaccine, so these vaccine, they will activate the same process. So now let's suppose this is your blood vessel. Here also, this is your platelet and it is showing your PF4, but here remember there is no heparin molecule. So there is no heparin, and in absence of heparin, this B cell activation happens. B cell activation, which leads to antibody synthesis, which binds to your platelet cells. And this leads to the activation of platelets, which leads to further activation of other platelet cells. So again, the same process which is happening here, the same process starts happening here, which leads to the thrombocytopenia. Thrombocytopenia. So it is a very simple process. Just you have to remember the PF4 molecule and your B cell activation is causing the activation of your platelets, which further activates other platelet cells, which are further coded to form the platelet. You can say the platelets, which they synthesize various kinds of molecule, which helps in the blood clotting. So one platelet cell is getting activated, it is further activating other platelet cells, which are activating thousands of platelet cells, and ultimately blood clotting is happening. So in terms of COVID-19 vaccine, if you talk about, there is no heparin, and the same process is happening without heparin. So it is non-heparin based, only COVID-19 vaccine based. So this is the total mechanism, what is the mechanism that COVID-19 vaccine is initiating your thrombocytopenia or your blood clotting. I hope you have liked the video. Thank you.